अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओम सहनावतु सहनौ सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्माणि जाति पूर्वं ये वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्ह देव मूर्ति प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो मह्यम। सुखम नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। In continuation to the third chapter, Guru Lakshana, it has been said that without Guru, there is no jnana possible. Shruti also says it. Independent study without guidance from the Guru can lead to erroneous conclusions. That is why we have many so-called sampradayas, which are not really sampradayas. ब्रह्मज्ञात् गुरोरेव फ्रॉम अ गुरु हू इज अ ब्रह्मज्ञ श्रोत्रिय एंड ब्रह्मनिष्ठ वेदार्थो ग्राह्यः द तात्पर्य ऑफ द श्रुति एंड द टीचिंग ऑफ द श्रुति शुड बी लर्न फ्रॉम ब्रह्मज्ञ गुरु यथा यथा धृतिमुखाद्वा घटमुखाद्वा गृहीतं समुद्रजलं सविलक्षण रसास्वादन हेतुर् न भवति तथा अज्ञपुरुषमुखाद् गृहीतं वेदरूपसमुद्रस्य अर्थरूपं जलं विलक्षणानन्दजनकं न भवति। सो व्हाट वाज सेड अर्लियर कंक्लूडेड अर्लियर ही इज कोटिंग एंड कंटिन्यूइंग फ्रॉम देयर इफ अ पर्सन पार्टेक्स दिस समुद्र जला बिकॉज वन हैज एक्सेस टू इट। सिमिलरली इफ वन सेज आई हैव एक्सेस टू शास्त्र अर्लियर इवन द एक्सेस वॉज नॉट देयर बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग इट वॉज प्रोटेक्टेड नाउ एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल फ्रीली टू एवरी वन टू एक्सेस बट इट इज प्रोन टू मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग जस्ट लाइक द सॉल्टी वॉटर कंज्यूम विल आई मीन हु वॉन्ट्स टू ड्रिंक सॉल्टी वॉटर ऑफ द समुद्र It will not serve the purpose. Similarly, Ajna Purusha Mukhad Grihitam Veda Rupa Samudrasya Artha Rupam Jalam Vilakshanananda Janakam Nabhavati. What will happen is that if a person studies on his own, it was concluded earlier that it will not lead to moksha, jnana. Similarly, even if one studies from someone who is not a jnani, Ajna Purusha, who does not know the tatpare of the shruti, he does not know aikya, and he keeps on teaching something or the other. Tatha ajna purusha mukhat grihitam veda rupa samudra. The veda rupa samudra, it is so vast, one may misunderstand what is the tatparya and teach that to the other. Swayam moodaha, anyan mohayati. So one who is himself confused, he will confuse others as well. So it will not lead to ananda, vilakshana. One's own, one is dukhi really, and vilakshana ananda is there, which is one's own swarupa. That one doesn't get, as in the jnana, that kind of a jnana. Veda rupa samudra se artha rupam, jalam. The jala which is in the form of artha jnana, which is really not aikya jnana. There it will not generate ananda swarupa. It will not lead to one's own ananda swarupa. There is no generation of ananda per se. It is removal of dukkha which itself is attainment of sukha because one's own swarupa is ananda rupa. Tasma ajnya patka guruhu druti ghatadi samaha. Therefore, one, the ajnya. Ajnya is similar to this. Tasma ajnya patka guruhu, one who is a teacher, who is himself does not have jnana. He is similar to the ghata which will bring in this samudra jala and will not really help, because the jnana will not stay. It is not with the guru, it will not stay with the guru, and therefore it will not come to the shishya. So here, I mean, this can be taken a leaky pot or something like that. So a leather pot. So earlier some leather was also used. So that is comparable. Tasma ajnya pataka guruhu dhriti ghatadi samaha. Like a leather cannot hold water, something of that sort, you know. So dhriti is in that sense. Or this ghatadi samaha, who cannot give you the vast, is not like a cloud which can pour rain, which is the Vedanta tattva. He can give you only little parts. So whatever, you know, water the ghata can hold, only that much. So that seems to be the comparison here. Jnani guruhu mega sama iti praguktam. Earlier it was said jnani is mega samaha. Yeah, so see, jnani guru mega sama. Compared to ghata or dhriti, which can hold less water. And it can hold less water means it is not even holding Mahavakya there. It is holding something other than that, because the Ajna Guru is not sure what to teach. Even if he knows the Tatparya, he may say that, you know, Shruti says so. I am not sure, but Shruti says so, because he himself is not convinced. He still has doubts pending. He himself does not know Aikya. Thereby he is compared to this Dhriti or Ghata, which cannot carry water, or if it carries water, it cannot hold. It leaks. Jnani guruhu mega sama iti praguktam. Whereas Jnani guru is compared to the cloud, which can show the entire thing. It can, you know, cover a large area. Other way, the clouds cover a large area. Similarly, he knows the how Shruti lands on the Tatparya, how the methodology goes. He knows multiple prakriyas. He uses what is right for the students, and thereby Jnani guruhu mega samaha iti praguktam. Tasman mukshu dhriti ghatadi tulyam ajnya pata gurum hitva mega tulya brahmajnya pataka, sorry, not pat, pataka gurum. So tasmat mukshu dhriti ghatadi tulyam ajnya pataka gurum hitva, giving up that kind of a guru who himself does not have jnana. Sometimes he teaches one way, sometimes he teaches another way. He himself is confused. He should give up that kind of a guru who is like a dhriti or ghata. Mega tulya brahmajnya guru mega tulya brahmajnya guru mukhad vedartha shravanam kuryat, and one should do shravana, follow shravana, learn from a guru who is mega tulya, because he has studied in the sampradaya which has led to culmination. It is manana siddha, meaning he does not have any doubts and he has nishtha. He is not confused about it and he knows the methodology, so he cannot confuse you also. Tad vijnanartham so guru mevabhi gachet samit pani shrotrim brahmanishtam. It was not quoted earlier, so now sadhu quotes that tad vijnanartham. Before this, adhikarityam should be there. The Mundaka mantra starts with adhikarityam here. Parikshalokan karmachitan brahmano nirvedam ayat. So after analyzing one's own experiences, lokan is lokyate iti loka. The lokam is experienced there. Lokyate iti loka, and lokan pariksha, having analyzed one's own experiences. Did I get what I want? Did it stay with me? Did the sukha, which is generated by Vishaya, how I understood that Vishaya generates Sukha, did that Sukha stay with me? Is it really generated by Vishaya? If one analyzes, then Vairagya is the right conclusion. It is the right result. Vairagya is the resultant of such Viveka, analyzing as to what is it out in the world that has given me Sukha, which I really want. And had it been there, everyone should have liked the same Vishaya. Everyone does not like the same Vishaya. And if I like something and Vishaya Sukha is there, even if it is individualized, still, why don't I get the Sukha every time I indulge with the same Vishaya? I don't get it. If I overdo it, then there is Dukkha, there is wear and tear. Sometimes I like something, sometimes I like something else. So that becomes the cause of this, against this, that, another becomes the cause of Sukha. So once one analyzes it, that it does not stay, it is not Nitya Sukha anyway, there is Vairagya. Nirvedam Ayat is, Nirveda is in the sense of Vairagya there. Ayat, one attains Nirveda and then Tad Vijnanartham. Then what is it that leads to Nitya Sukha? That is tad vijnanartham sa guru meva vigachet. One should approach the guru samit pani with the seva bhava shrotriyam brahmanishtam. This is literal. If the guru is has an ashram, as in he is a sannyasi and has an ashrama where vaidika karya goes on, he has brahmacharis, or it is seva bhava. So if the guru is a grahastha or has an ashrama where there are grahasthas and brahmachari, then samit pani, if they follow vaidika today, very little is followed, but then if there is a temple so where homas are done, so samit pani is carrying samit. So carrying samit pano yasya sa samit pani hi, one who carries samit, meaning with the seva bhava, that I am willing to serve for the knowledge, that is the bhava shrotriyam brahmanishtam, we have seen earlier. Upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tattva darshina, says Gitacharya Krishna. So smriti pramana is also there, ityadi shruti smriti bhyav. And once, you know, upadekshanti te jnanam, there it is, unable to recall there. So the prashna, you know, one should serve the guru and inquire into the tattva, that is said there, and then upadekshanti te jnanam, te jnaninaha jnanam upadekshanti, which, who are those jnanis? Tattvadarshi. Tattvadarshi jnanis will give that knowledge. Ityadi shruti smriti bhya. Paurusheya prabandadapi jnanam jayeta. Now, Paurushya prabandadapi jnanam jayeta. Brahmavin mukhadeva vedartho grahitavya iti purvavarte uktatvad vedanta vakyartha vicharena eva jiva brahmahikya jnanam jayeta. Natu itarehi paurushayehi samskrita grantherva bhasha prabandherva iti siddham. So now, this is a thinking now. If it is said that the shruti leads to moksha, shruti is apaurusheya. It has not been created by anyone. It is not a result of a, it is not a human creation rather. It's not human, any elevated human also, or even Ishvara is called as Purusha. We say Ishvara manifests the Vedas also, but it is not a creation of Ishvara. Somewhere Bhagavan Bhashyakara says that it is created by Ishvara. But if you look at it, Ishvara is said to have created the world. And to create the world, he has to have jnana. Where is that jnana? That jnana is one with him. So he has Vedas in his antakrana itself. That jnana is one with him. Then he recalls, it is said that he recalls the Srishti as it existed in the earlier Kalpa, and then remanifested this prapancha to continue from there. So that jnana of how to create, that is also there in the Vedas, which he had before creation. So before creation of then if you say if he created Vedas and take it literally, then how can he create Vedas which tell him how to create the world? Because Vedas are part of the world. Therefore, with a jnane, that vid dhatu is in the jnanartha, which is already there. Then he manifests that in the forms of words which are accessible to others. That is the idea there. So the jnana is already there. Vedas are already there with Ishvara. And when Ishvara manifests the prapancha, the Vedas become manifest. So it is not created. It is not even really created by Ishvara. That Aikya Jnana, which is the Tatparya, can be known only through such kind of a Shruti. So, Paurusheya Prabandhadapi Jnanam Jayeta iti Vaktum na Shakyate. This is the Purvapakshi Vichara, which is presented and then refuted. Now, this Apaurushiya Grantha Shruti alone can lead to knowledge, not the Paurusheya Grantha, if that is the objection, he says, Brahmavin Mukhadeva Vedartho Grahitavya, it was said, iti Purvavarte Uktatvat, since Purvavarte Uktatvat, in the earlier Avartana, it was said, 113, it was said that only from Brahmavit one should study the Shastrartha. Vedanta Vakyartha Vicharena Eva Jiva Brahmaikya Jnanam Jayata. Therefore, only through Upanishad Vakya Vichara one will get this Brahma Jnana Aikya and then Moksha. Natu Itaraihi Paurushehi Sanskrita Granthairva Bhasha Prabandairva Iti Siddham. Therefore, one will not get Jiva Brahma Aikya Jnana through the Paurushya, human created Granthas, whether in Sanskrit or when in other languages. It is any language if you use, you say, no, I'm using Sanskrit, but is it Paurushya Grantha or Apaurushya? Is it Shruti or another Shruti? If it is other than Shruti, then you will not get Aikya Jnana. This is the objection, really. Asya Prabandhasya Paurushyatvad Arambho Vyartha iti Ashankayam Uchyate. When such a doubt comes about, then it is said, Sayo Havai Tat Param Brahma Veda Brahmaiva Bhavati. He is using a very different approach here. You saha yaha havai, indeed tat param brahma veda, one who knows that param brahma, brahmaiva bhavati, is a shruti vakya. Brahmaiva bhavati, he becomes brahma. One who knows brahma becomes brahma, says Mundaka Upanishad. Ityadi shrutya, and there are other shrutis also, brahma vijnani brahma eva. So brahma vijnani, one who knows Brahma is Brahma. Brahma eva. Ata eva tasya vak veda rupa eva. So tasya vak veda rupa eva. His speech, that's why, you know, when you say that Jnani Guru has said it, generally there are people who are scholars, you know, or wanting to be scholars, they ask, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Jnani has said it, like Bhagavan Bhashyakara says something, oh, show me the Shruti. Bhagavan Bhashyakara shows the Shruti also, but if we don't get the Shruti, if he says iti Shravanat, iti Shrute, if we don't get it also, we know that several Shrutis are lost in the Sampradaya. So when he says something, it has a Shruti backing. Even if it is not exactly so, it is a paraphrase Shruti. We don't know where it is, but it is definitely that Shraddha should be there unto the Guru and Sampradaya and the Shruti. Shruti says so, I have Shraddha in the Shruti, but I don't have Shraddha in the Acharya. He is teaching something else. If that idea is there, then one will have a questioning mind. It is not that the questioning shouldn't be there. The questioning should be there as to, I do not understand what is being taught, but to say that, oh, where is this? Give me that. So that the focus goes away. If you, during the study, if one keeps on, you know, I want to have a scholarly attitude of, you know, marking each and everything, where is it during that? It's okay to mark it. It is useful for references to look up and all that. But during the teaching itself, one has this idea, oh, where is this said? Where is that said? There are people who interrupt the patha also while studying. Even when I was, where is this said? Where is that said? So what does that show? Either it shows a scholarly approach at the cost of understanding, or it shows that I do not trust my Acharya. I do not trust my Guru who is teaching as to what is he saying, where is this? In a debate, it is okay to ask, but during learning, it is not right. सो ब्रह्म विज्ञानी ब्रह्म एव अतएव तस्य वाक वेद रूपा एव सो दिस इज द अप्रोच साधु इज यूजिंग दैट इफ ही इज ब्रह्म देन व्हाट ही इज टीचिंग इज हैज टू बी फ्रॉम व्हाट ही हैज स्टडीड एंड इट इज लाइक ईश्वर वाक इज वेद इफ इट इज सेड ईश्वराज वचन इज वेद देन दिस ज्ञानी बिकमिंग ब्रह्म हिज वचन इज ऑल्सो वेद सा च वाक् संस्कृत रूपा वास्तु भाषा प्रबंधादि रूपा वास्तु लेट हिम टीच इन एनी लैंग्वेज इन संस्कृत और एनी अदर लैंग्वेज मॉडर्न लैंग्वेज इज फॉर द मॉडर्न क्राउड सर्वथा तस्य वचनं भेद भ्रम निवर्तयति निशेषम इट विल टेक अवे दि भ्रम ऑफ भेद दैट देर इज अ प्रतीति ऑफ भेद बट वन थिंग्स दैट भेद टू बी रियल ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ भेद जीव ब्रह्म भेद जीव जीव भेद जीव जड़ भेद जड़ ईश्वर भेद देन जड़ जड़ भेद ऑल दीज फाइव भेदास आर रियल इज द थिंकिंग बट इट विल बी टेकन अवे बाय दिस ज्ञानी हु नोज ब्रह्म एंड सिंस ही इज ब्रह्म विच इट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट ही हैज लर्न दी श्रुति फ्रॉम दी संप्रदाय एंड देन ही हैज बिकम अ ब्रह्म विच सो ही नोज ए मेथडोलॉजी ऑल्सो ही मे यूज सम अदर लैंग्वेज But it is in keeping with the Shruti. Therefore, Bheda Brahman, Tasya Vachanam, Tasya Jnaninaha Vachanam, Bheda Brahman Nivartayati, Nishesham Nivartayati, not only takes away completely. Nanu Vedanta Vidyana Sunishchitarthaha, Tantopanishadam Purusham Veda, Ityadi Shruti Bhir Veda Vakyadeva Brahma Jnanam Jayeta, Natu Pramana Bhutairapi Prabandantara, Prabandantarair Iti Chenna. So if the objection is by quoting Shrutis, sorry, Manu, Vedanta Vidyana Sunishchitartha, these Jnanis are Vedanta Vidyana Sunishchitartha. They know the Tatpare of the Shruti and therefore this Jnana has become Sakshatkara Vidyana, Sunishchita and it is ascertained meaning. There is Nishtha there and what kind of Purusha does the Shishya want to learn? In Brihadaranyaka, he says, Tanto Upanishadam Purusham Veda. I want to, the teacher teaches what, or he knows. What does one know? One knows that Purusha, which Purusha? That Purusha who is Upanishad Purusha. As revealed in the Upanishad, not any other. Not any in Purushaya Grantha. इत्यादि श्रुतिभिः वेदवाक्यादेव ब्रह्मज्ञानं जायेत न तु प्रमाणभूतैरपि प्रबन्धान्तरैरिति चेन्न नॉट थ्रू अदर लैंग्वेजेस एंड अदर यू नो दीज संस्कृत रूपा कैन बी टेकन एज दी स्मृति ग्रंथास पुराणास इतिहास इत्यादि एंड भाषा प्रबंधास आर वन सेल्फ इज पुटिंग टुगेदर इन दिस ईरा सम बुक्स रिटन बाय ज्ञानीज Those are prabandantari. So, prabandantari. Okay, looks like I have some trouble pronouncing this. Pramana bhuterbi prabandantarir iti chenna. If that is the objection that these will not lead to jnana, only shruti vakya will lead to jnana, iti chenna, tatha adarshanat, it is not seen in that manner. Why so? He gives an example, Ayurvedokta Roga Tan Nidanastha Nidanasthana, sorry, Ayurvedokta Roga Tan Nidanasthana Ushadadinam Jnanam Itara Sanskruta Vaidya Granthaihi Prakruta Bhashadi Granthaisha Yatha Samameva Utpadyate Tatha. So example is, one has Roga and Roga Nivritti should take place. Now in the earlier setup, before you had modern medicine, allopathy, etc. Ayurveda is the medicine. Now, Ayurveda is the source. It's a Vedanga and it is the source of all the medicines and all the remedies for diseases. Now, Ayurveda ukta roga tan nidana sthana aushadadinam. Those aushadis which are aushadas which are mentioned in the Ayurveda Grantha to take away the roga, the jnana which comes about by Ayurveda study is sufficient. You cannot say that only that in the Ayurveda. Only those, I want only those. Now, based on that jnana, jnanam itara sanskruta vaidya granthaihi prakruta bhashadi granthaischa yatha samam eva utpadyate. if one is studying that, you cannot say that teach me only Ayurveda. Somebody who has studied Ayurveda, he knows what has been taught there. He writes some work. He says that, okay, these are the list of diseases. These are the remedies. He knows very well as to what should be used for what. Now, he creates a grantha. It is a Paurushiya grantha. Ayurveda is also, it's a Vedanga. Let's assume that Ayurveda is not directly studied by these doctors or the even one who is actually using the remedy. Can be the diseased also, patient also. But he is studying the grantha, a book created by someone who has studied Ayurveda. That does help. Because it is the same thing that is taught in the Ayurveda, he is paraphrased in his book, easier to understand, whether in Sanskrit or in another bhasha, Prakruta bhasha. Taihi cha yatha samameva utpadyate. Through those books also, how that jnana which is born is same as that which is born from Ayurveda. Because I know that the remedy for this disease is this. Thereby, similar is the case in the exemplified also, tatha sarvesham pratyak chaitanya bhinna dvitiya brahma jnanam api paurushya granthair api jayate eva. So similarly, the jnana is born even from paurushya grantha if it follows the shruti. For everyone it is so, pratyak chaitanya abhinna advitiya brahma jnanam, that brahma jnana, aikya jnana, I am not different from brahma, that jnana is born even from paurushya grantha, from not only from Shruti but also from Smriti, from Itihasa Purana, Prakarana Granthas, in any language also, if a new book is written, then I mean not only a book, the teaching, it should be book in a sense. I'm saying that following that book, if someone is teaching who already has studied in the Sampradaya but he is teaching a particular book, then also it will lead to. So grantha study, because this grantha is written, the way it is written is in keeping with the Shruti methodologies. Therefore, this grantha will also lead to moksha. That is the idea. Ata eva sarvajnyair munibhihi maharshivi brahmanishtaihi vedantartha anuvadakaihi smriti itihasa puranadi bahu granthair advitiya brahmatma vidya sputam vivruta vartate. So the vivarna, the expanse of the teaching is there in the Bhashya, in Tikas, Prakarana Granthas, Tika on those Prakarana Granthas, or Vivarna on those Prakarana Granthas. All of these are there in Smriti, Itihasa, Purana. Everywhere the same Brahmajnana is there. Bahu Granthaihi, Advitiya Brahmatma Vidya Sputam Vivruta Vartate. It is presented in a very elaborate manner for ease of understanding. Similarly, in this grantha also, Vina Upanishada Jnanam Chenna Utpadyeta Tada Taihi Smrityadi Pranayanam Vyartham Prasajyeta. If Jnana is not born out of Upanishad, not born out of anything other than Upanishad, Vina Upanishada Jnanam Chenna Utpadyeta. If it were really so, then Tada Taihi Smrityadi Pranayanam Vyartham Prasajyeta. All those Smriti, Itihasa, Purana, all these are not for a pastime activity. They are also for Jnanotpatti. So they would be Vyartha. They would be a waste. The creation itself is waste, creation of this Smriti Grantha. It is not that the Rishi Munis didn't have anything better to do that they started creating Smriti, Itihasa, Purana, Ityadi. There is a teaching involved in that as well. Dharma as well as jnana leading to moksha. Tasmad upanishadam avirodhena atmaswarupa pratipadana paraihi yaihi kaischidapi granthair jnanam jayeta eva iti abhyupagantavyam. Therefore, it has to be accepted. Abhyupagantavyam, that the jnana is born out of any kind of granthas, kaichidapi granthaihi, which are paraihi, which are committed to pratipadana, revealing what? Swarupa, which is atma swarupa, which is, it is not opposed, it is in keeping with the Upanishad. So, tasma upanishadam avirodhena. the pratipadana granthas, those which reveal this atma swarupa, they should reveal this swarupa yathavat avirodhena, not opposed to the teaching in the Upanishad. So it need not be exactly. There can be a new methodology also. As Bhagwan Sureshwaracharya says, that any prakriya is okay as long as the culmination is in aikya. So any grantha which uses a new methodology also is fine. We should not question the methodology if it leads to aikya jnana as revealed in the Upanishad. Tat pratipadaka vakyani vaidikani vasantu bhashantara bhutani vasantu naivasti vishesha. There is no difference in the jnana which is born. So whether it is through the Vaidika Vakyas as in, you know, paraphrase or as quoted verbatim in the book or in the Grantha, if it is paraphrase also, it is irrelevant because it will lead to the same Aikya Jnana. Tat Pratipadaka Vakyani Vaidikani Vasantu Bhashantara Bhutani Va Naiva Asti Vishesha Asmin Vishaye Evancha Paurusheya Grantha Rapi Jnanan Jayate Vaiti Siddham. Therefore, through Paurushiya Grantha. Here the Purvapakshi is talking about this Grantha specifically. So when all other Granthas can lead to Moksha, Paurushiya Granthas, if they follow the Shruti, why not this Grantha also? That is the conclusion here. You missed some Tippana there. Let me see if there is anything important in Tippana. Okay, Shlokas quoted there for one here. What is the point there? Bibhetyalpa shrutadvedo mamayam pratarishyati itihasa puranabhyam vedam samupabhruhyet achinoti shastrartam acharyasthapayatyapi swayam acharate yasmad acharyastena kathyate gukaruhyandakarasyat rukarastanyavartakah brahmandakarana shitvat guru ityuchyate budaihi. So Guru Lakshana is mentioned here. Brahma is mentioned here first. How? Itihasa puranabhyam vedam. So this Brahma which was talked about, Brahmi Vriddhau, that Brahma and Abhaya Brahma actually, otherwise from Dvitiyadvai Bhayam Bhavati, that is talked about, Acharya Lakshana, the definition of Acharya is given, who knows and follows, himself follows, Swayam Acharate, who knows the Shastrartha, he teaches and he knows, he has Nishta in that. And then Gukara Andhakara, we saw another verse with a similar meaning, who takes away Ajnana of the Shishya. Paurushe Vedanta Prakrana Granthair Jnanam Na Jayate Iti Vadan Vadi Prashtavya. Now one who says that the Granthas created by humans, human creations cannot lead to Jnana. Jnanam Na Jayate. From those Granthas, Jnana is not born. He should be asked. The objection, the person who raises the objection, Purva Pakshi, he should be asked. Prashtavya. What should he be asked? Kim tadrisha granthairi veda vachananu sarit ananusaritvad or ananuswari bhavat. So kim tadrisha granthaihi veda vachana anusaritva abhavat na jnanam jayeta, meaning ananuswaritvad, just because they do not follow the shruti granth veda vachana, they do not follow veda vachana, is that the reason that jnana will not be born? Uta or Vedarthanu Saritva Bhavadvaiti. So Veda Artha they do not follow or Veda Vachana they do not follow. What is your objection to, O Purva Pakshi? Are you saying that Jnana will not be born due to these Paurushaya Granthas? Because one, they do not follow the Veda Vachana as it is, or they do not follow the Vedartha Tatparya itself. What is the objection really? Veda Vachananu Saritva Bhavad Iti Chet. If it is the first one, that it does not follow the Veda Vachana as it is. Smriti Itihasa Puranadi Nam Api Tatha Tatha Tvat Tebhyo Api Jnananutpatti Prasangaha. In Sampradaya, it is accepted that those who do not have Adhikara in the Shruti, they can study the Smriti. Everyone has Adhikara in the Smriti. If Smriti is also difficult, then Itihasa Purana, all these are there. Kramena, they are easier. Shruti is more difficult to understand. Smriti is less difficult. Itihasa is the way. Itihasa is way we have seen our ancestors have had the knowledge and how did they get it. So we see in their life, to understand their life, itihasa, it was so, itihasa, it was indeed so. So that is itihasa, it is the history, and history, how did the ancestors live, what kind of a life did they live, how did they study, what exactly did they study, and how did they attain moksha, that is the study of itihasa. So it is not just history, it is the, in their life, how did they attain moksha, that is the real study there. And Purana also, various Puranas through various Devatas and their own teachings. Shiva Gita, Devi Gita, all these are teaching the same thing. In the Puranas also, if there are some Gita Vakyas hidden there, they are all the same. Aikya Tatparya, Aikya Tatparya. Thereby, Sampradaya says that Aikya taught anywhere, Devi, this Aikya Jnana will definitely lead to moksha, and Aikya Jnana will definitely be born out of these. If you even study that, the way it has to be studied, the way the Tatparya is found, you have to find in the Smriti Itihasa Puranadi Granthas also. Then Tathatvat means they are also not following Veda Vachana as it is. It is not a parroting of Veda Vakyas. They paraphrase it, they elaborate it. Therefore, Smriti Itihasa Puranadi Nam Api Tathatvat Tebhyopi Jnana Utpatti Prasangaha. There won't be Jnana born out of those if the Purvapakshi's objection is valid. Atha Vedartha Anusarikva Bhavad Iti Chen Tanna. Meaning, this Prasanga here, it would be so, but it isn't so. Because Sampradaya accepts that Jnana can be born out of Smriti Itihasa Purana, etc. Now, if you take the other possibility, atha vedartha anusaritva bhavad iti chet tanna, if the tatparya is not followed, if that is the objection, yatha bhava smriti puranadayo grantha vedartha anusarinaha eva tatha samskrita prakrita bhashadi maya vedanta prakarana grantha api bhavo vedartha anusarinaha bhavanti eva. That is not a valid objection. Why? Because just like smriti puranadi granthas, all these granthas are also following the Tatparya of the Vedas. There are many Granthas and there are many parts to Granthas, but the Tatparya is same, the Vedartha. It is the Veda Tatparya, Vedanta Tatparya, Aikya. Similarly, Samskruta Prakruta Bhashadimaya Vedanta Prakarana Granthapi. Similarly, these other Paurushya Granthas, whether be it in Samskruta or Prakruta Bhasha, all those are Vedartha Aru Sarini. Sarinaha, they are also following the Tatparya of the Shruti, therefore they'll also lead to Jnanotpatti. Yathat cha Ayurveda anusari Samskrita Prakrutadi Grantha Roga Tannivartaka Aushadadi Jnanam Janayanti Tatha Vedartha anusari Samskrita Prakrutadi Vedanta Prakrana Grantha Api Advithi Atma Vidyanam Tad Upaya Jnanam cha Janayayuhu Eva. So he uses the same example in the Mula, just like Ayurveda leads to the knowledge of the Roga Nivritti. Similarly, the other Granthas based on Ayurveda also lead to Roga Nivritti Jnana, Roga Nivritti Jnana. Similarly, here whether you study Upanishads or the Paurushaya Granthas, they'll also teach the same Advitiya Jnana, Advitiya Atma Jnana. Therefore, Advitiya Atma Vijnanam Tad Upaya Jnanam cha means also the knowledge about the tattva as well as the methodology or the means of getting that jnana is also born from these granthas. Further, in the Mula, Shri Guru Seva. So Guru Seva is elaborated here. Yasya Brahmavido Vak Veda Vakya Sama Tameva Brahmavid Vidam Tameva Brahmavidam Acharya Buddhya Upasita Acharya Buddhya Upasita Jidnyasu. So Jnatumichu Jidnyasu, one who wants Jnana. Now I recall that the earlier, sorry, Pariprashnena Sevaya. So the Gita Vakya there is Pariprashnena Sevaya. So Pariprashna and Seva, both are there, or Pariprashna itself is a Seva. Some take that meaning also. Because sometimes these days, Seva is not possible. There are a lot of others for Seva. So Guru Seva opportunity is lacking. which is very unfortunate. We don't have the opportunity to serve the Guru. Guru Seva has become Ashram Seva today. But then, because Guru himself has access to modern life today, then there is not much Seva to be done there. So, Ashram Seva for Chitta Shuddhi. Otherwise, Guru Seva leads to lot of Chitta Shuddhi, and it taps the grace of the Sampradaya also. The teaching flows quite smoothly. So there is no dvesha. That's why we do Shanti Mantras in the beginning. So it takes away whatever possibility of dvesha is there. So here, Jijnyasu Jnatum Ichchu, what should he do? He should have this buddhi of this Acharya. Acharya, as defined earlier, that Acharya, this is my Acharya, so Brahmavit, he is Brahmavit, and that kind of Brahmavit Acharya, Seva should be done. Upasita, so Upasita, one should approach him and then serve him and learn. Veda Vakya Samatameva, so Vak, his Vak is, Brahmavit Vak is same as Veda Vak. Therefore, I will get the same thing that is there in the Shruti. With this idea, one should serve the Guru. Yada Upasanaya Guru avarjito bhavati tada jijnyasu nijaswarupam aparokshi karoti. And then what will happen? One will make this jnana aparoksha jnana. Jnana will become aparoksha. When the Guru teaches, then this jijnyasu nijaswarupam aparokshi karoti. This swarupa, which is ever there, but has as unfortunately become paroksha, as though paroksha, because of all the noise and misunderstandings, therefore it appears to be paroksha. Now through the jnana it will become aparoksha. Etena guru seva abhyadikeshwara seva ataha iti siddhyati. So sevata, sorry, etena guru seva abhyadika ishwara sevata iti siddhyati. See, ishwara seva cannot be done. Ishwara seva cannot be done in the sense, it is not direct. It is invoking the Lord in the murti, and any murti, and then doing the seva. Or upasana also, you have to invoke the Lord. But here, Guru is pratyaksha, who, if you see, the idea is that if I want to get Brahmajnana, I cannot assume that I will get Brahmajnana, but my Guru does not have Brahmajnana. Meaning, I will become Brahma when I get Brahmajnana. This is the idea. The reason we are all studying is Brahma Veda Brahma Iva Bhavati. So Brahma Veda, me, I who will know Brahma, will become Brahma. As though figurative becoming, but I can become Brahma, but I discount the Guru as Brahma. That should not be the approach. That is the idea that every Shishya looks upon his Guru as Brahmavit. This is a Sampradaya. You look at every Matha following, they treat their Acharyas as Bhagavan. It is not one. I cannot say that my Guru is Bhagavan, your Guru is bogus. So this is the attitude of the Shishya for one's own selfish interest. It need not be for anything else. I need Jnana. Jnana can come only from Brahmanishta Guru, who is Shrotriya. And, I doubt whether he is a Brahmajnani, but I want Brahmajnana and I will become Brahmajnani. This attitude does not work. We should not keep on discounting. It is not in our interest to discount all sorts of gurus and hold on to, only one who is a vague idea from the Shastras. So here, Ishwara Seva, what we have done, has led to Chitta Shuddhi and has led to Guru. Now, if the Ishwara Seva and Guru Seva has a conflict, that is mentioned here, etena guru seva abhyadika ishwara seva abhyadika. Guru seva abhyadika is better than ishwara seva, because ishwara seva is led to guru seva, one. And second, we have already said that brahmavid brahmaiva bhavati, or brahmaveda brahmaiva bhavati. Therefore, guru is not different from ishwara. So sakshat ishwara taya guruhu sevaniha. That is the idea here. It is siddhyati. Ishwara Seva Adrushta Phala Matra Hetu. Further, if you analyze, Ishwara Seva will give Adrushta Phala, Punya Janaka. Sadguru Seva to Drushta Drushta Ubhaya Phala Hetu. Sadguru Seva will lead to Drushta Phala, as not only Adrushta Phala, it will give Punya also, and it will give Drushta Phala also, right here in this life itself. Dharma Dharma Utpatti Dwara Phala Hetu Yobhavati So Adrushta Phala Hetu Riti. by generating dharma, dharma adharma, dharma adharma utpatti dvara phala hetur yaha bhavati sa adrushta phala hetur iti. Ishvara is dharma and adharma utpatti dvara phala hetu. He gives phala. Ishvara is karma phala data. What kind of karma? That which has led to dharma as well as adharma, punya and apunya, punya and papa. He is adrushta phala hetu. Where dharma dharmotpattim vina eva sakshat phala hetur yo bhavati sa drushta phala hetur iti cha uchyate. And who is drushta phala hetu? Who can give the phala which I get it here and now? Only one who can give without the punya and papa being involved. So without punya and papa being involved, guru can give me something. There is no punya which is coming from jnanotpatti. So that jnanotpatti is leading to drushta phala. And it is without punya and apunya, therefore guru is drishta phala hetu iti uchyate. Ishvara seva dharmotpatti dvara antakkarana shuddhi roopa phala hetur bhavati. Again in contrast, Ishvara seva leads to dharma, and through dharma I do not want the phala of punya. Punya phala in the sense I don't want swarga ityadi. So it leads to antakkarana shuddhi, as described earlier in the earlier chapters. Ataeva Ishvara seva adrushta phalayetu. Therefore, how it works on Chitta Shuddhi, oh please show me, that will not work. The phala here, antakkarana shuddhi rupa phalahetur bhavati Ishvara. So Ishvara aradhana will lead to Chitta Shuddhi if I do not want the punya to lead to swarga ityadi. Sadguru seva tu dharma nirapeksha acharya prasada matrena upadeshatmaka phalahetur bhavati. If the guru is pleased, the guru will give me jnana. So guru seva will lead to, without the dharma being involved. What dharma? As in, that it will lead to some particular dharma as prescribed in the shastras. If I do something, then it will lead to adrushta. That adrushta will give me sukha later in life when it will be ripe for fructification. None of it, that is there. That is also there. Because you Guru Seva, Ishvara Seva is not different. Ishvara will take any Seva offered through any Murti. It be it a live Murti in the form of the Guru. Guru Sharira is no different. It is like an idol, and if one does Seva, Aradhana, Ishvara will partake of that also. Because he is there in each and every form. So there is no difference whether it is Jnani and Ajnani also really. But Jnani has a specific Upadhi as disclosed in Tattva Bodha Ityadi. Because Brahma Veda Brahma Bhavati, it is like having sakshat access to Ishvara. So dharma nirapeksha acharya prasada matrena. If the acharya becomes pleased, then he will give more and more. Otherwise, you know, some get irritated. Oh, not now, later. But the please, the grace has to be invoked. Just like we invoke the grace of Ishvara. Even in the dharma shastra, it is said, this is how you do the Ishvara aradhana. If you do it any other way, then Ishvara is not pleased. What has to be offered, when it has to be offered, all the rules have to be followed. If one does not follow the rules, then they sometimes say, you know, if you do this, this particular Lord will be angry. Dharma Shastras do talk about that. No, it has to be done only in this way. This is the methodology to follow. What to be offered, when to be offered, to please the Lord. Similarly here, so, for example, Alankara Priyaha, Vishnu is Alankara Priya, whereas Shiva is Abhisheka Priya. What does that mean? If you want Shiva's grace, then you offer more and more Abhisheka. Now, if you say, no, I'll bring gold and do Alankara of Shiva, where do you see Alankara of gold on Shivalinga? Very rarely. Kavacha may be there, but it is not a regular activity. Abhisheka is a regular activity. Shiva likes Abhisheka. So if you want the grace of Shiva, you have to do Abhisheka. Similarly, Vishnu, if you go and do Abhisheka, Vishnu is not pleased. Okay, you do Abhisheka, you have to bathe him. But if you say that I'll bathe you throughout the day, he does not want that. He wants you to do Alankara. If you offer more and more flowers, you know, good clothes, you offer, all sorts of ornamentations, he is happy. He is happy faster and more. That is how you tap the grace of Ishvara. So here, Acharya Prasad Dharma Nirapeksha Acharya Prasad Matrena Upadeshatmaka Phalahetur Bhavati. The Upadesha is the phala. I want the teaching is. So, you know, people say difficult to find Acharyas, difficult to find. But are we shishyas? Do we have the shishya bhava? Without that guru, there is no guru really. Guru and shishya connection is only, see, one becomes a teacher. If you take the most basic meaning also of guru, one becomes a teacher only when there is a student. Pooja Swami used to say that. One can be a teacher only when there is a taught. If there is no student, how can he be a teacher? Therefore, I become a student only when, only then my guru, then I can call someone a guru, someone as a teacher also. I have to be the student. So, Acharya Prasada Matrena Upadeshatmaka Phalahetu Bhavati Tasmat Drishta Phalahetu Sadguru Seva Ityuchyate. So, therefore, from this Upadesha, there is Drishta Phala. And from there, all this is from Guru Seva. This is said here. Kincha Sadguru Seva Dharmotpatti Dwara Antakkarana Shuddhi Rupa Phalahetuscha Ishwara Seva Vad Bhavati. And similarly, there is Adrashta Phala also doing Guru Seva. Therefore, you get a twofold result from Guru Seva. Ataha Adrashta Phala Hetu Rapi Bhavati. Therefore, Guru is also Adrashta Phala Hetu, not only Drashta Phala Hetu, which is in the form of the teaching and its result. Echena Acharya Seva hi Ishwara Upasanataha Adhikatara Vijnayate. And therefore, Sampradayavadi say that, you know, Ishwara Seva and Guru Seva, if you compare, then Guru Seva is Adhikatara. Tasma Sarvata Jidnyasu Mukshubhi Sri Sadguru Varaha Brahmanishta Eva Sada Sevyaha. Therefore, one should take the superior and Seva as superior. And even there are Smriti Granthas which say that one should not make the Bheda between Ishwara and Guru, which is there in Sampradaya. Those who have studied culturally, we have that Kulu Guru, Mata Guru, all these have, we have Adara, we have respect, and we look upon their words as Ishwara Vak. Anyway, so we'll stop here, we'll continue in the next part. Sukham Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Nama Rupayo Adhishtanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukyatva Nirmanam Aparam Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Param Mahaha Tadevaham Tonyat Iti Menishchitamatihi. Any questions? Namaste, I'll see you in the next part. Huh?